Hi, let's talk about the cystic artery. In this video, we'll discuss the typical branching pattern of the cystic artery and the boundaries of the hepatobiliary triangle. The cystic artery is the blood supply to the gallbladder. So in the removal of the gallbladder, the cystic artery must be ligated. Therefore, it's of great consequence that one understands the origin of the cystic artery. The cystic artery's most common origin is from the right branch of the hepatic artery proper. If it doesn't originate from the right branch of the hepatic artery proper, there are several other sources for it. It may come from the left branch of the hepatic artery proper. It may come from the hepatic artery proper. It might come from the gastroduodenal artery. It may come from another branch of the celiac trunk, or it may even come from a branch of the superior mesenteric artery. So one must look for it. As it is quite variable in origin, it's important to know that one of the most frequent places that you can locate the cystic artery is within the hepatobiliary triangle. The hepatobiliary triangle has three sides. The superior side is the visceral surface of the liver. The inferolateral border is the cystic duct. And the medial border is the common hepatic duct. So in the majority of cases, the cystic artery will be conducted through this hepatobiliary triangle. There are instances where it does not, but this is the most common place to look for it. Now, one thing that I will caution you, it's very frequently referred to as the triangle of Callot. But the hepatobiliary triangle is not technically the triangle of Callot. Callot's original description of this space included the same medial and inferolateral borders, but the superior border of the triangle of Callot is actually the cystic artery. But more often than not, you'll hear people confounding the hepatobiliary triangle with the triangle of Callot. So we've discussed the cystic artery, the importance of locating its origin, the greatest potential for origin of the cystic artery, as well as the preponderance of cases involving the cystic artery moving through the hepatobiliary triangle, and how that is not the same thing as the triangle of Callot. This is your summary slide. Thank you very much for your time.